And this comes as we're also getting a rare look at life inside North Korea in a remarkable, secretly recorded footage from the critically acclaimed documentary Beyond Utopia. Just take a look at these never-before-seen satellite images of a gulag and listen to the man who survived it, losing 91 pounds in the matter of just a few months there.
왜냐하면 부패가 돼가지고 사람하고 사람 싹 엉켜붙었고 한 명씩 뛸 수가 없어요. 왜냐하면 다 부패됐으니까 떨어져서 팔 당기면 팔이 빠져나오고 다리 빠져나오고 머리가 뚫렁 떨어지고 하는데 큰 이런 리아카 같은 그런 데다 밀차이다.
Also featured in the film, North Korean defector Hyeonseo Lee. Erin spoke with her and with the director, Madeleine Gavin, about this BAFTA-nominated film.
I am so grateful to be with both of you and to see you again, Hyeonseo. Madeleine, let me start with you about this access. We just looked at those satellite images. You were able to obtain those. No one's seen those before. You've got videos of defectors leaving, brokers on the China-North Korean border are working with them. You've got their actual escape. You've got video of police abusing North Korean defectors, Chinese police, that was presumably CCTV of some sort, but you were able to obtain it. How did you get this access and footage?
Yeah, so there's actually three different sources for what you talk about. The satellite imagery of the gulags is from the Committee of Human Rights in North Korea. In Washington, D.C., and there was obviously a whole process involved in getting clearance for that satellite footage. In terms of the footage inside North Korea, including the, torture footage, but also just footage of people on the street.
Yes.
This was during the research phase when I was researching the film, and this is what drew me in to making me want to make this film feel like actually this film needed to be made because, I was feeling the pulse of people inside North Korea, seeing people inside North Korea living real lives. And there was like a stark contrast between what I was seeing there and what we see in terms of what is actually allowed out of North Korea by the Kim regime. And essentially what we are able to see usually is what the Kim regime wants us to see. So finding this footage was like finding a treasure trove of a horrific reality. And, and I realized there's 26 million people in that country and we're really not hearing from them.
I mean, it is incredible because some of the footage, I'm looking at it going, my goodness, right? And to your point, 26 million people and yet we don't see their lives. I mean, Hyeonseo, you were a child in North Korea. Obviously you lived there until you were 17. And I know when you defected, it had to be so secret you couldn't even tell your mother. But in the film, Hyeonseo, you talk about some of your childhood experiences and it's incredible. You talk about practicing for those mass games. Now, some of those images are things that the Kim regime does want the world to see. All those children performing in unison. But here's how you described it, Hyeonseo.
We usually practice on the cement. So kids were rolling on concrete for months. Some kids even broke their jaws when they fell on the ground.
I mean, Hyeonseo, these children, as you point out, were as young as 5 years old. You talk about how school was canceled because children needed to witness executions. You saw one when you were 7 years old. Now you have Kim telling women in North Korea to have more children, that there's a real issue with the birth rate. Do you believe the hesitancy that women there have in having children comes from any of this, comes from them seeing the suffering of their own children and their own experiences?
First of all, the babies, when they're born, the baby's die rate is super higher than the other countries. And also because of the starvation or lack of, food, everything, people, women, they don't want to marry or they don't want to have kids.
I mean, Madeleine, North Koreans, as among the many things they're taught, Hyeonseo is, referring to, right, the ignorance, right? They're taught certain things, they're not exposed to other ideas. It's a psychological study of what could happen to any group of humans, right? And yet they're taught from an early age, for example, that Americans are evil. Some of the propaganda that North Koreans grew up with and Hyeonseo grew up with, there's these images, North Americans are going to kill you, right? In the film, you interview a woman. This really stood out to me, 80-year-old grandmother. So she fled from North Korea. She defected with her family. But what was amazing is she made it very clear she fled because her family fled. and she felt that she would be targeted if she stayed. So her reason was pragmatic. It was not political. It was not, unprincipled. And she said this.
북한이 제일 좋다고 아직도 생각하는가?
그래. 어떻게 말하면 말해?
어떻게 말? 아이 말해도 이로써 엄마 생각대로 그대로 뭐 말하면 돼. 아프면 아프다 좋다면 좋으면 좋다. 그래서 그거는 그거 그대로 이제 내보고 눈 가르보며 말하지 말고.
김정은 원수님께서도 이번에 이렇게 우리 진나에 정말 숱한 인민들을 매개 살고느라고 많은 노력을 많이 합니다.
아, 엄마. 엄마, 엄마 거짓말 하지 말아야지. 엄마 언제 그 김정은이 준 쌀을 먹었다 그런 거짓말 하지 말아. 엄마 그대로 말하라 소리야. 언제 쌀을 먹어본 일 거짓말 하지 말고.
That's incredible.
Yeah, I mean, it's, it was so amazing to spend time and get to know the Roe family along the way and to watch the sort of what I call the unpeeling of an onion, you know, of, for instance, Grandma, who for 80 years had believed in her bones, in her blood. I mean, she believed wholeheartedly in the Kim regime. Mm-hmm. She had tremendous guilt toward Kim Jong Un. She was extremely angry at defectors for abandoning him. And to watch her kind of grapple with what she's known to be true versus what she was experiencing and how she would kind of go back and forth in this dialectic within herself. But yeah, she defected only because she felt she had to. She had no choice. Her daughter was going. I mean, the family was going to be banished, so they would not have survived if they had stayed in North Korea. But nevertheless, if she thought she could have stayed on her own and made it, she would have.
It's amazing. Hyeonseo, when you and I met in Seoul, in 2015, you didn't want the cameras to show where you lived because you were afraid that North Korean agents would find you. And at that point, you hadn't lived there for many years. But one of the things, Hyeonseo, that I have never forgotten about our conversation then is that you told me that if you had to do it all over again, because of all of the difficulty that you faced after leaving North Korea, that you would have stayed. And now that you have done this film and you see everything there, you see others who have left, and you have lived now another 9 years of your own life. Do you still feel that way?
Yeah, you know, on the outside, I might look normal, but on the inside, still I'm suffering from enormous pain because I left my relatives and friends, and I had to be separated from my family for 14 years and 17, left behind 17 years of memories. So still the pain stays with me wherever I go. That's why I was doing to international community to raise awareness about issues. So at the end, many people, if you know about these issues, we have the power to end this modern-day tragedy.
Hyeonseo, thank you so very much. And thank you very much, Madeleine, as well. And I hope everyone will see Beyond Utopia.
Thank you.